A little knowledge goes a long way, especially when that knowledge guides our decisions along the journey. That's the essence of the trajectory-based operations concept. In short, TBO is an air traffic management concept that enhances strategic planning under changing conditions, providing the information and capabilities to help expedite aircraft movement between origin and destination airports. TBO will shift from a voice-based set of exchanges between participants to an environment primarily involving data sharing and exchange across interoperable systems supported by global data standards. See how TBO is shifting the decision-making paradigm, moving from a tactical approach to a more strategic one. Currently, tactical actions are taken because some information is only available at the moment. These add up, and operators pay the price by loading more fuel. If we had greater access to the information, we could, and we would, make more strategic decisions ahead of time instead of reactive course corrections. But by continuing to allow a tactical paradigm, we waste time and fuel. Imagine having access to the information you need, when you need it, and having it tailored to improve decision-making. Data exchange technology has caught up with this vision, and now we have the capabilities to make it happen. Through improved strategic planning and management of traffic flows, TBO will reduce reactive decision-making. This will increase predictability and efficiency, while further optimizing the ATM system to meet the diverse airspace user needs. And that brings us to the next exciting phase of TBO, validation. In phase one, we forged international partnerships and established overall operational scenarios. And now in phase 2A, we'd like to share how we have used the mature operational scenarios and multi-regional technical capabilities to validate data exchange requirements and TBO functional needs through execution of a full end-to-end multi-partner lab demonstration. But before examining the scenarios, it's important to understand the operational values driving the TBO concept. First, enhanced predictability. This is a common plan shared among stakeholders, supported by the same trajectory information to mitigate confusion. Second, increased reliable flexibility. TBO provides flexibility in accommodating trajectory changes while maintaining business objectives as conditions evolve and change over time. This supports individual airspace user decisions, such as reducing the amount of contingency fuel carried, knowing capabilities are in place for adjustments when more information is available, thus reducing fuel burn and emissions. Third, improved strategic planning. This mitigates deterministic delay factors, improves network performance, and more equitably distributes delays. Fourth, decreased uncertainty. This is the idea that improved trajectory accuracy decreases uncertainty in the system. And fifth, alignment of strategic plans and tactical actions. This is accomplished through sharing, management, and use of the trajectory as a common framework. These TBO operational values were exhibited through a series of scenarios. These operational events, based on actual flights, were developed to demonstrate, in a laboratory environment, specific capabilities and data exchanges. The first scenario addressed four aircraft departing the United States, bound for Asia. Developed in partnership with Japan Civil Aviation Bureau, it demonstrated interactions between the FAA, NAV Canada, JCAB, Civil Aviation Authority of Singapore, and airspace users throughout the end-to-end scenario. This complex scenario demonstrated several TBO concepts, including FFICE R1 and R2 services with pre- and post-departure negotiation across multiple EASPs, flight data sharing using the flight information exchange model, use of a digital constraint reflecting letter of agreement or LOA requirements, and sharing and managing trajectory information using CDM. Scenario 2, in collaboration with NAV Canada, consists of two aircraft, one departing Seattle-Tacoma International to Toronto Pearson International, and the other departing Vancouver International to Toronto Pearson International. The scenario demonstrated tactical deviations needed by ATC, as well as EAU strategic negotiations before and after the tactical intervention through the end-to-end scenario. Key components to this scenario included uncertainty due to de-icing and strategic negotiations to avoid turbulence. Scenario 3 is a collaboration between AeroTai and JCAB and showcases both pre- and post-departure processes in an FF-ICE TBO environment. This scenario demonstrated FF-ICE R1 pre-departure planning and FF-ICE R2 airborne trajectory revision due to the activation of an airborne ATFM measure as a result of changing weather conditions. Scenario 4 is a story of two connecting Singapore Airlines cargo flights operating from Tokyo Narita International Airport, Bangkok Suvarnabhumi International Airport, and Singapore Changi International Airport, with a stopover at Bangkok, an ACDM airport. The demonstration included sharing a common trajectory across FF-ICE-capable and non-capable ASPs, as well as the full turnaround process at an ACDM airport in an FF-ICE environment. Scenario 5 is a continuation of the Los Angeles International Singapore Changi Airport routing in Scenario 1. This scenario, led by CAAS and supported by JCAB, demonstrated the complexities and value of digital exchanges when collaborating across multiple FIRs and explores connections across regions with an emphasis on discovery of FF-ICE R2 services and their benefits. From this informative lab demo, the team emerged with several key takeaways, including the following. 1. TBO is about sharing, maintaining, and using the trajectory as a common reference across actors and regions, and we have demonstrated this is possible. However, there are some areas where additional development will be needed in existing systems to ensure future requirements will support TBO. These include tactical and strategic integration, as well as the processing of the agreed trajectory by downstream EASPs. 2, the global data exchange standards have been further validated and are foundational to the success of TBO. Specific items learned in the demonstration will be used to continue the development of data standards, including both flight and flow exchange models, as well as the aeronautical information exchange model, which was used to express the flight constraint from the digital LOA. 3, the proposed International Aviation Trust Framework, as demonstrated, was sufficiently flexible to meet a range of stakeholder security needs, with the flexibility supporting each participating EASP to determine how best to implement the specific security measures needed. And finally, the continued evolution of the connected aircraft enabled the sharing of more information across relevant stakeholders, resulting in the flight crew's active, collaborative participation in strategic planning. We're committed to realizing the promise of trajectory-based operations. Working with industry partners, we are already engaged in the next phase of the journey, exploring a multi-regional TBO live flight demonstration. Follow our journey as we set out to improve strategic planning and management of air traffic, and see where knowledge can take us next.